The next individual in the lineage of human evolution that we are going to talk about is Homo habilis. This Homo habilis, these are also called as handymen. Also called as handymen, or these are also called as tool makers, because they were the first in the human evolution who started making tools. First to make tools, and they make tools by stones and bones of other individuals or other organisms. They were first to make tools, therefore they have also been called as handymen or tool makers, and they used to make tools by the stones and the bones of the other individuals. Their fossils has been excavated from excavated from Africa. Remember this, the fossils of Homo habilis also been excavated from Africa, and by the same scientist Leakey, which has also discovered the fossils of Kenyapithecus. He had also discovered the fossils of Homo habilis. And around 2 million years ago, it is found out that around 2 million years ago, their fossils have been excavated. Now, the fifth one that we are going to talk about is Homo erectus. In the lineage of human evolution, that flow chart that we had studied, the Homo erectus, these were involving three types of Homo erectus. The first one was Java ape man, the second one was Peking man, and the third one was Heidelberg man. So these Homo erectus, their fossils have been excavated around 1 million years ago, and three types of individuals are present in Homo erectus. The first one is Java ape man, second one Peking man, and the third one is Heidelberg man. Now, these Homo erectus, they were having some more evolved characters or some more specific characters. They were more closer ancestors of human beings, or we can say that they were more closer ancestors of the modern man. So we will discuss the characteristics one by one. The first one is Java ape man. their scientific name is Homo erectus erectus. Java ape man, their scientific name is Homo erectus erectus, and their fossils have been excavated by Du Bois. Remember the name of scientist here also. Their fossils have been excavated by Du Bois from Java. Therefore, these are known as Java ape men. They were more closer ancestors of men, and also they were carnivorous. Again, by knowing their tooth structure, we estimated that these animals were carnivorous because they were having long and sharp canines. Carnivorous, and they were having long and sharp canines. Their cranial cavity or cranial capacity is about 900 cubic centimeter. These are the most intelligent, or we can say that most sophisticated individuals from these Homo habilis, because they are belonging to the class Homo erectus. So they were more closer to the human beings, or more closer to the modern man. So because they were more closer to the modern man, their cranial capacity also increased. So their thinking power, or the type of work they were doing, that has been also enhanced by increasing in their cranial cavity. So these were some characters of the Java ape man. We have to remember here the name of the scientist and the name of the place. Du Bois is the person who has discovered the fossils of Java ape man from Java. Their fossils have been discovered from Java, therefore the name is also given as Java ape men. And they are more close ancestors of men, so their cranial capacity is ultimately increased up to 900 cc, and they are carnivorous, their canines are more sharp and long. The next we are going to discuss is about Peking man. Peking man, their scientific name is Homo erectus pekinensis. Homo erectus pekinensis. This is the new name, or the new scientific name given to the Peking man. The old name was Sinanthropus pekinensis. This was the old name, and this is the new name. New scientific name is Homo erectus pekinensis, and old scientific name was Sinanthropus pekinensis. They were very similar to the Java ape man. That is, they were also nearly closer to the human beings, and they were also carnivorous, having long and sharp canines. But their cranial cavity was different. Their cranial cavity increased to that of Java ape man and increased up to 1075 cranial क्यूबिक सेंटीमीटर. अप टू दिस देयर क्रेनियल कैपेसिटी वॉज इंक्रीज्ड 1700 क्यूबिक सेंटीमीटर. नाउ द थर्ड वन दैट इज हिडलबर्ग मैन. हिडलबर्ग मैन देयर न्यू साइंटिफिक नेम इज होमो इरेक्टस हिडलबर्जेनेसिस एंड द ओल्ड नेम वॉज पिथेकैंथ्रोपस इरेक्टस. और हियर ऑल्सो साइनेंथ्रोपस पेकिनेंसिस और पिथेकैंथ्रोपस पेकिनेंसिस वी कैन से द ओल्ड नेम ऑफ द पेकिंग मैन. एंड हियर न्यू नेम इज होमो इरेक्टस हिडलबर्जेनेसिस एंड ओल्ड नेम वॉज पिथेकैंथ्रोपस इरेक्टस. नाउ their fossils were discovered by the scientist Scotton Sack from Heidelberg. Heidelberg was the name of place and their fossils have been discovered from Heidelberg. And these were called as the connecting link between the pecking man and the Java ape man. These were called as the connecting link between pecking man and Java ape man. So we have discussed about three individuals in the Homo erectus. The question may also ask like this, that which of the following individuals have been involved in the Homo erectus. So the answer will be Java ape man, pecking man and Heidelberg man. Or sometimes they eliminate this Heidelberg man from the category of the Homo erectus. So the answer will be Java ape man and pecking man, or the Homo erectus erectus and Homo erectus pekinensis. These remember these scientific name, they can also give in answer the scientific name, not the common name. So what were the characteristics we have discovered about the Java ape man? The name of scientist we have to remember here, it is very important. Du Bois has discovered the fossils of Java ape man from Java, and they were the most near ancestors of the modern man with the cranial cavity of 900 cubic centimeter. And they were carnivorous because they were having long canines and sharpened canines. The next is pecking man. They were similar to that of the Java ape man. The only difference in their scientific name and in the cranial cavity the organisms were bearing. Their cranial cavity is more than the Java ape man, up to 1075 cubic centimeters. Now the Heidelberg man, their scientific name is Homo erectus Heidelbergensis, and the fossils were discovered by Scotton Sack from Heidelberg. And these are also called as the connecting link between the pecking man and the Java ape man. So these were the three individuals which were involving in the Homo erectus, and these were also eliminated, or these were also extincted after some time. The next link in the lineage of human evolution that we are going to discuss about is Homo sapiens. Now we are going to discuss our last lineage of the human evolution, that is the last species, that is Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens, these are most evolved type of individuals. And also have the cranial cavity between 1300 to 1660 cubic centimeters. And they were most evolved individuals having the cranial cavity of 1300 to 1660 cubic centimeters. In some books it is also given as 1600. Now, they were considered as the most cultured and civilized. They were the most cultured and the civilized individuals present in during the lineage of human evolution. And the again three types of Homo sapiens were involved. The first one is Neanderthal man, their fossils were discovered by Fulrott. The name of scientist is Fulrott. Remember the name of scientist, the Fulrott, who has discovered the fossils of Neanderthal man. From Neanderthal Valley in Germany. He has discovered the fossils of Neanderthal man from Neanderthal Valley, which is present in Germany. And as we said that they are the most cultured and the civilized persons. So, civilization first started by these Neanderthal men, and they were also considered as the sophisticated type of men. Their cranial cavity is about 1350 cubic centimeters. They were the first omnivorous animals or the first omnivorous individuals, because their tooth structure or the dentine structure was very much similar to that of the human beings, that resemble to the teeth structure of human beings. Therefore, we estimated that the Neanderthal men are omnivorous individuals. And these animals or these individuals also started living on a particular place. They were having their proper residence. So, these were the first cave dwellers. They started living in caves. They started making caves and they started living in that caves. So, they were the first cave developers or first cave dwellers also. Their speech center was also evolved. Neanderthal man was the first individual whose speech center was evolved. their only speech center was evolved, they were not able to produce any kind of, they were not able to talk between themselves. Only they can produce the kind of voice between them to have some signals or to show some instructions, only they used their voice. But they were not having any mode of communication or any language between them to communicate. They can only produce some kind of voice from their voice box, that is larynx. Their speech center was developed. And they started ceremonial burying of dead bodies. They were the only first who started the ceremonial burying of dead bodies. As we told earlier that these were the cultured and civilized, so they started burying the dead bodies instead of making the tools and other things from their dead bodies. They started making, or they started ceremonial burying of their dead bodies. These were the some characters of Neanderthal men. What are these? The scientist who had discovered the fossils of Neanderthal man was Fulrod, and he has discovered the fossils from Neanderthal Valley from Germany. And they were omnivorous individuals. They were the first cave dwellers. They started living in caves, and their speech center was also developed. So they were able to produce some kind of voices between them to show some instructions and anything. And they started ceremonial burying of their dead bodies. And they also developed some tools between them for hunting or for any other purposes. They also developed tools. Now the next man or the next individual was, the first one was the Neanderthal man, the second one is Cro-Magnon man. Their scientific name was Homo sapiens fossilis. These were the second in the Homo sapiens, that is Cro-Magnon man, and their scientific name was Homo sapien fossilis. These were having the largest, or we can say that they were having the cranial cavity of 1660 cubic centimeters. These were the largest cranial cavity bearing animals. And here one question arises that though they were having this large cranial cavity, so what was the reason of their being fossilized? क्या रीजन था कि वो एक्सटिंक्ट हो गए? उनके पास में इतनी ज्यादा क्रेनियल कैविटी थी, ह्यूमन बीइंग से ज्यादा क्रेनियल कैविटी दे वर बियरिंग, सो व्हाट वाज द रीजन फॉर देम टू बी फॉसिलाइज्ड? सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन इन द ह्यूमन इवोल्यूशन लीनिएज, दैट व्हाई द क्रो-मैग्नॉन मैन हैज बीन फॉसिलाइज्ड दो दे वर हैविंग द मोस्ट डेवलप्ड टाइप ऑफ क्रेनियल कैविटी. And these were the first individuals to use fire. They started using tools and they started using fire. Now, they are more civilized than Neanderthal man. And they were also omnivorous. they were also omnivorous because their dentine structure is also similar to the men. Dentine structure similar to men. So these were some characteristics of the Cro-Magnon men, that their scientific name is Homo sapiens fossilis. Their cranial cavity was most developed among all the organisms, that is 1660 cubic centimeters. They were the first individuals who use fire. They become more civilized than the Neanderthal men. They were omnivorous and their dentine structure is similar to that of the men. These were the some characteristics of the Cro-Magnon men. And one more, that their fossils were discovered by MacGregor. Their fossils were discovered by MacGregor from Cro-Magnon. The place from where their fossils have been excavated, that place name was Cro-Magnon, and the scientist who have discovered the fossils of Cro-Magnon man, his name was MacGregor. Now these were the two individuals, that is Neanderthal man and the Cro-Magnon man. We have not written the scientific name of Neanderthal man, I think so, yes. Their scientific name is Homo sapien Neanderthalensis. Homo sapien Neanderthalensis, the scientific name of Neanderthal man, and the scientific name of Cro-Magnon man is Homo sapien fossilis. The third and the last one is Homo sapien. The last one is Homo sapien sapien. These are considered as the wise men, and they are most civilized individuals. These are wise men and they are considered as the most civilized individuals. The Homo sapiens sapien has been divided into the four categories or four types of individuals, or four categories we can say, according to the region, according to the types of region in which the individuals are living. It has been divided into the four ethnic spaces. The first one is the Eastern. Here Eastern individuals comes under the India, China, etc. That is in the eastern part. The second one is the Mongoloid individuals. They were belonging to the Mongolia. Now the the third one are Negroid. They belong to Africa. And the fourth one are Caucasia. They belong to Europe. So these were the four ethnic spaces or four ethnic type of individuals which has been divided under the category of Homo sapiens sapiens according to the regions. That eastern individual were living in the eastern part are they were belonging to the India and China. Mongoloid, they belong to the Mongolia. The Negroid, they belong to Africa, and Caucasia, they belong to the Europe continent. So this was all about the Homo sapiens and all about the human evolution we have completed now. The Homo sapiens, which are the most evolved and highly civilized individuals, they have been divided into three categories. The first one is Neanderthal man, their scientific name is Homo sapiens Neanderthalensis. The second one is Cro-Magnon man, Homo sapien fossilis, and the third one is Homo sapien sapiens, which are considered as the wise man and the most civilized type of individuals. Now we will discuss about the difference between the man and apes. Now we will discuss about the difference between man and ape. The first one, apes are belonging to the class Pongidae and men belonging to the class Hominidae. The second one, they led arboreal life, that is they live upon trees, and they led terrestrial life. Third one, they were walking on four limbs, and they used to, or they were walking on two limbs, that is on the hind limbs, and they use all their four limbs, all their limbs, that is two forelimbs and two hind limbs. And the fourth one, their forelimbs are much larger, or we can say that their forelimbs are longer than their hind limbs. And in the men, their forelimbs are smaller, they have longer hind limbs in the case of men, and in the case of apes they were having longer forelimbs and shorter hind limbs. Fifth one, they were having opposable pollex and hallux, and in the case of men only opposable pollex, non-opposable hallux. What do you mean by pollex and hallux? Pollex means thumb and hallux means toe. So in the case of apes, they were having both opposable pollex and hollex. Imagine the toe in the opposable conditions like hand, that these are the fingers and we are having the opposable thumb. And in this situation only they were having the fingers of their hind limb also, that the fingers were in the normal position and the toe is opposable to them. The both pollex and hollex are opposable. And in the case of men, they were only having the opposable pollex and non-opposable hollex. We are having the opposable thumb and non-opposable great toe, the toe in the same direction of the fingers. Now, the sixth one, they are having developed canines. Why they were having developed canines? Because they all were carnivorous, and here no developed canines because they were omnivorous. Seventh, diastema is present between the teeth. Diastema means the gap that is present between the incisors and the canines, that is called as diastema. We have seen that some of the individuals today also, they are having the gap between the incisors. So that gap between the two teeth is known as diastema. So in the case of apes, diastema is present, but in the case of men, diastema is absent. So these were the some differences between the apes and men. What are they? The apes are belonging to the class Pongidae and men are belonging to the class Hominidae. They led arboreal life and they led terrestrial life. They walked on four limbs, they walked on two limbs, that is hind limb, only hind limbs, and their forelimbs were much longer than their hind limbs, their forelimbs were smaller. They were having opposable thumb and opposable toe, but only they were having the opposable thumb, that is pollex, not opposable toe. They were having developed canines and they were not having that much developed canines, normal canines. Diastema is present and here diastema is absent. So these are the some differences between the apes and men. And one more thing, that they are having, the men are having the bipedal locomotion. And these were not having the bipedal locomotion. Why they were having bipedal locomotion? Because of lumbar vertebrae. Because of lumbar vertebrae, they were having bipedal locomotion. Here, no lumbar vertebrae is present. So, they are having no bipedal locomotion. Now, there is only one curve in their vertebral column, and here four curves are present. Four curves are present in their vertebral column. So these were some basic differences between the apes and men, which you have to remember, because questions might ask on this difference or on the characteristics of the apes and men. And the three apes were orangutan, gorilla and chimpanzees, and men involved the modern man, or we can say that the Homo sapiens or Homo sapiens sapiens. So this was all about the human evolution.